Okay, so now that we set our reference and we've set up the tester, we've verified our test reference codes, we're ready to test. In front of me, I have a loop of cable here. And the remote unit is connected at one end here, and the main unit is connected at the other end here. So I'm ready to test. So Amanda, go ahead and hit the test key for me. And in 3 seconds, boom, we've got our test. That's 850 and 1300 nanometers on each fiber, fully standards compliant. You'll also notice we've got our green boxes here. That's indicating our loss, and it's pointing to which fiber it's referring to. Go ahead and hit one of those green boxes for me. So you can, if you want to, drill into detail. And in here, you'll see what the loss actually was at both wavelengths and the limit that was calculated based on the length of the fiber measured and how many connectors that you put in the tester, along with that test limit that you selected.
What is this green circle indicating?
Oh, the green circle here, that's indicating which fiber that I'm actually looking at for those test results, a little enhancement we put in, because sometimes it can get a bit confusing as to which fiber that you're looking at. Let's go back. So with our test that's actually passed, let's go ahead and save the test result. So our cable IDs are pre-configured already, so it's populated 01A and 01B.
What if I hit this?
If you hit that, it actually rotates it. So this is now 1B and this is 1A, because sometimes you can get in a situation where the polarity is actually wrong, what the tester thinks it actually is, depending on how you plug those codes in. If you were to do this and save it, when you go to save the next result, this fiber up here is going to be 02B and this will be 02A. So we'll actually remember you flipping that. But we do have it the right way around today, so I'm going to get you to put it back. And we'll tap save. Again, we're saving two results at the same time. Unlike the DTX, that was two separate actions. So no danger in saving just one fiber, and that used to happen with certain DTX customers. Tap the cable IDs. Excellent. Up in the corner here, you're going to see the option to autosave. Let's turn on autosave. And done. And test. This is going to really speed up your testing now, because once that test is done, again in that miraculous 3 seconds, it's automatically saved the result. And we know it saved the result because when you look at the boxes, you're going to see the cable IDs in bold in there, and we know the results are saved. If they weren't saved and we just hit the test key, the test would warn us that we didn't save the results. So it's not like you can just continue testing and not realizing you're not saving. So again, in the real world, we would disconnect from our fibers here, connect back into our next fiber, and hit test. This is so quick that most of your time now is spent disconnecting and reconnecting fibers. It's not spent on time on actually testing the fiber as well. And we can only do all of this because we set it all up correctly. We pre-configured our test limits and our cable IDs all in advance. That is how you successfully test fiber. So in the next video, I'm going to show you how to get the results out of this tester and create that all-important test report so you can get paid.